Consent agenda approval. Any questions on the agenda?
No, just verbal vote.
Okay, the girls that want to discuss adding volleyball and activity are in practice, and they may be here a little later, so we'll probably go to that when they get here. Okay? Minutes. Any questions on the minutes?
Can we approve all the ones that we have to do?
So we do.
Three meetings, the activity one separate.
I think we can do all together.
We usually do them all at once.
Okay, financial report.
I don't think there's anything out of the ordinary on the financial.
Okay. Claims.
Some contract payments, all right?
We got that taken care of?
I met with him, and he guaranteed it.
Okay.
You know, we have any problems, 10 years, I believe. He didn't know if it was 5 or 10, but we know any tears that come up, and they'll fix it, so we just need to keep an eye on it.
So you were happy?
I was happy, talked to him. He said next time we need to get the carpet square, so.
Yeah.
He says, I know they're more expensive, but he said.
Then we spill something, you can.
Yep, in the long run, it's better.
They look nice in here.
Yeah.
One of the things he did talk about was, you know, those little tops that are showing up. He said, actually, when they make those carpets now, those are only about so long, so if they pull, it's just a short piece. Well, it used to be, if you caught one of those, it ripped the whole thing out.
New clocks over across the street or something?
Yeah. Did what?
New clocks, yeah, $625,000 clocks.
What we did on that, and I don't know when they did this, several years ago, they bought clocks that were synchronized through a, actually, it's a clock, I think it's a Mr. Clock's office. Well, we got an invoice on that, I don't know, earlier.
Summer.
Might have been this summer, that they wanted to charge us, I don't know how much money to, for new software for those clocks. You know, we did replace some of them with these atomic clocks or whatever anyhow, so we just decided we're just gonna do away with that. And then we had to buy some clocks for over in the elementary, that's less than what it was gonna cost for that software update, so.
Yeah, when I was in elementary before, none of them said the same time. I mean, one would say 12:05, and one would say 12 o'clock, and one would say 12:03. I mean, it makes it tough for the teachers.
Treasure, you have one that's ahead.
Yeah.
And these are, I don't think these are atomic clocks we got, but they operate the same way that they're supposed to synchronize.
Okay, any other questions? Entertain a motion?
I so move to accept the consent agenda as written.
Okay.
I'll second.
Moved and seconded, approve the agenda, consent agenda. Steve?
Yes.
Vicki?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Motion is approved. Public comments. We have a portion of our agenda set aside for public comment. Each person wishing to address the board will be recognized by the board president. Also, each person wishing to address the board will be allowed only one opportunity to do so this evening. Request that you limit your comments to 5 minutes or less, and we will advise you when that 5-minute time period has elapsed. Please remember that this is a public meeting for the conduct of the business of the Plainview Public School District. Offensive language, personal attacks, and hostile conduct will not be tolerated. You should further be advised that there is no legal protection for any comments that are made. Are there any public comments?
Yes. I actually want to, because I know you're gonna go into a discussion, but I want to be heard also as a parent, not just the principal of the school.
Okay.
We're gonna talk about co-oping. Today was the first day in the history of the school that we've had to cancel a game due to lack of numbers. And that is a huge concern. Next year we'll be fine, the next year we will not. And I know that people say, we don't need to do this, we don't need to do this, we've gotta get kids out. When, and keep in mind that this isn't, when I say my kids, I'm talking about all of these kids in the school, not just my son. There is possibly 13 or 12 kids that will be out for football this senior year. And that's if everybody stays out, everybody goes out, and basketball is the same, wrestling is the same. There isn't a sport that isn't feeling the crunch. We are canceling a junior high game today because we don't have enough kids to take. And you get to that 12 and 13 number, there's six teams, I think, I read in the paper this week that have had to cancel their season because there is not enough kids to participate. And we will lose kids. Whether we think that this is not important, it is important. It is important to me. It's important to my family. We live for these things. Now, granted, I realize school is about academics, and he does have to maintain good grades as well. But, you know, the idea that this isn't even going to be an option for him, he'll go play fall baseball. And he can go play that in Yankton. I mean, why? At least if you co-op, he has, and I realize we're at the beck and call of, you know, we're at their mercy, basically. If they say no, we don't have much of a choice. But for future purposes, we have to plan farther ahead than waiting till right now to try to do this. Because, and I know that it's been a topic of conversation, but then you go, I sat in those meetings when we were talking merging, and people said, we don't need to do any of this. We don't need to do any of this. We have numerous kids walking the hallways that aren't out for hardly anything. I used to coach here. I had 45 girls staring me in the face at volleyball. I don't need 45 girls to play volleyball. You were really good at distance. Why don't you go play cross country? Mr. Knock, you got room for golf kids. I mean, we had the numbers. We don't now. And I might not be the only parent that's sitting here thinking that. And some people think, who cares, you know? But it is a huge thing. We might not have a varsity. I mean, you can play basketball with six kids. That's all you need to go out for basketball. But how competitive is that for them? When they say, and I'm talking fast because I only have 5 minutes. When we say, well, we don't want to do anything, then somebody's got to take that step and say, then you got to get your kids out. I don't know how to make kids go out for things. We've tried. But that's a huge concern of mine as a parent that he's going to, I don't care if he stands on the sidelines. I don't care if it's with Osmond, I don't care if it's Creighton, Wausau, whoever. He may or may not get to play, and everybody always says, oh, he'll get to play. I don't know that. Looking at him right now, probably not. I see one sophomore on our team that would probably step up and play right now. And it's not my son. But at least he'd have the opportunity to stand on the sidelines and do something. So there you go.
Thank you.
I also want to comment on the co-oping thing, and I really hope the board takes an initiative with this. I want to go on the aspect that it is a changing world. We do have changing. Our society is changing. Our kids are changing. No, not everybody goes out anymore, and that's not just Plainview.
Nope.
It is a reoccurring conversation with all these small schools right now. If you ever go to Huskerland Prep's message boards, you will read thread after thread after thread about we had to cancel this game, we had to cancel that game. It is a theme throughout the state of Nebraska. And I'm not just talking about athletics either. I think it's time for us to start looking at big pictures and what's best for kids as far as competition goes, as far as what's best for them. It isn't the way it used to be, and I keep hearing things, oh, but our numbers in the elementary. That is awesome. We've also had those numbers in the elementary. Robin Reed went through our high school right now. He had predicted we'd have this many seniors, this many juniors, this many sophomores out for different activities, and they're not. And because it is a changing world, and because there are other things that they are pursuing. So we need to give what we can to the kids we have. And if that means we have to put our pride aside in a few different areas, that's what we're going to have to do. If it means that Michelle Mosel needs to say, you know what, we need to co-op our speech team with Creighton and there might not be a spot for me as a coach, that's the way it goes. But you gotta ask yourself what's best for the kids in this district. Last year we filled our speech team, our varsity speech team, with freshmen at districts. They were in positions as speakers that they shouldn't be. They're in positions on the basketball court, on the wrestling team, on the football field, in the volleyball. They're cross-country, everything, as very young kids, and they're not being allowed to develop the way they should develop as individuals. They're not getting those chances as a freshman, with a freshman schedule, with a JV schedule. they're being forced to be adults for big kids before they should be big kids. And I hope we do something for these kids. And remember, it's about the kids. It's not about us. It's about what's doing best for Plainview Public Schools students. It's not about, oh, this is all about me. It's about our students.
Thank you very much.
I feel the same way as both of them. I've seen my son playing at the varsity level when I really don't think he was ready. I think he would have benefited more by playing JV football for a few years. And I see a lot of kids that are getting injured, and I wonder if that's because they're put out there too soon when they shouldn't be. And bottom line, when you get to be in high school, you want to win. You don't want to lose all the time. And we're doing a really good job this year. We're having a pretty good season. But even if it's a losing season and we're competitive, it's a lot better than losing and just coming to expect losing. Even like I see it when I go to the games, kids aren't very enthusiastic. Like, people don't stand for they don't have pride, it seems like, here. You know, they don't stand for the school song. They don't, they just don't support the other kids. It's all about, it's me. What's it going to do for me? If it doesn't do anything for me, then I'm not going to go out. And I just feel like I'd like to see a little more competition also.
I have a question for you, and I'm not against this by any means. Because we're kind of on a time frame here, but first of all, if we vote and we can get Creighton or Osmond to vote by then to do this, are you guys all right with us setting up all the details after we decide to do it?
We trust you, Mike, yes.
I mean, I'm not saying me or us,
Annie,
or be a committee or whatever.
The board. Yes.
But
we
you're all right with that?
Yes.
And how it comes out?
I can speak for, I would say safely, I've talked to just about almost everyone on staff. And I'm not going to say 100%, but I would say our staff definitely recognizes the need for this. It's desperate at this point.
And we have to be ready for the fact that we won't get everything.
That's right.
And it's okay.
I just am wondering how it's going to be decided, if it's Creighton or Osmond, or how you're deciding which school to approach first. I don't know.
We're going to talk about this in a little while here in one of our discussion. I would just talk about co-oping those programs, and I can give you more information at that time.
Okay. Are other parents aware? I mean, I know there have been little bits and pieces here and there, like in the paper, alluding to the fact that maybe we are looking at co-oping, but I wonder how many people realize it's kind of a serious thing that we're discussing, that it's on the agenda.
Well, we talked about this all through the consolidation deal, what the numbers are going to be and what sports is going to be. So if they didn't get it through that, they probably aren't going to get it. They don't care.
Okay. I'll just add one note to that. I think our fear, I'm not going to speak for everybody, is not that co-oping isn't our fear. Our fear is that not moving quickly enough that we have the opportunity to co-op.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, that we have some choices to make, that we're not left out of this.
And I probably should have moved myself.
I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying we may
lose out on the opportunity of football, because that's the 1st of November. You have to have that all. In fact, the paperwork has to be done a couple of days before. Excuse me, before that. But we're going to keep pursuing it. Any other comments? Girls here, can we move the, just discuss adding the softball as an activity. Let's move that up for the girls here. Go ahead. Yes. Introduce yourself. So you
okay.
Tell us who you are and everybody.
You can stand up too. Don't leave me hanging.
Right behind you.
All right. Well, as far as you know, we're wanting a softball program. That's probably as much as you know. And
who are you guys?
I'm Jordan Anderson. Carissa Walker.
And I'm Brittany Walker, her sister.
Okay.
And I'm not sure that it would occur that we could make this all work for the seniors, because the season for softball is almost done. But, well, for first of all, the season for softball in high school is against volleyball, girls golf. It's a fall sport. And one reason why we would want to pursue having this sport is in the summer, a lot of the people around in town go off to Norfolk, Creighton, other places, and they spend their money traveling out of town, going all over the place, when we could have one right here, sanctioned by the high school. And yeah, that's that reason. Simply, it would cost a lot less for us if we had one here in town versus outward. Another reason we would rather have it in the school, other than just a league on the, our own in the summer by ball backers, whatever it's called, is because it's broken up into two-year age divisions, 14 and under, 16 and under, so on. And this way we could have it as 4 years. You could have, can you have junior high? I think you can.
No, it's not. Freshman.
But freshmen up to seniors can play on the same team for all 4 years instead of having to split off in between. So you would have more people. So far we have, how many people?
12 or 15. In between 12 and 15.
We have a couple maybes. So we have people in the range from 12 to 15 girls that would be willing to go out for the sport. And we would have double the number of girls?
Yeah.
Nearly double the number.
And
if we
talked with Osman, there'd be 5 or 6 more girls over there that would come over.
And I don't know if they're wanting to have a school team for Creighton, Osman, wherever we're going, but I do know that if Creighton's very into softball, I do know that. And if they were wanting to have a school team, then we could very well make it work with them as well. One other thing with Creighton or Osmond, whoever we decided to go with, we would have enough to have a varsity and a JV team, not just one team, but so we get more playing time in for players and they don't have to sit the bench the entire time, things like that, make it fair. And
it's not something that's gonna stop after the eighth grade class to the senior class right now, it's just gonna stop. This year, our 8 and under team had 20-some girls on it for the summer thing, for the summer league, and the 10 and under had 15 up in that range. So it's going to keep going on. It's just not going to be a 5-year thing and then just be done.
The thing that we're losing in the summer league is we... What was it? Why do we have some less people?
Yeah, we'll go off. They're going off to bigger towns. Like, there was 4 of us that went to Norfolk, 2 went to Creighton, a few of them, like, before Tessa went to Norfolk, she went to Osmond. It was, everybody's just splitting off. No one wants to stay in the town. They want more of a competitive field.
And that would be because we have less people that want to do it in a 2-year age range. If we had them combined, we would have more people. More people would want to play if they can play with, say, their friend from a different age group, something like that. Cost. Each player, I believe, could support their own bat, helmet, and if not, they can borrow someone else's. No. You're shaking your head about it. Sorry. One thing we would need to buy is uniforms. Pretty sure we don't have any. And possibly catcher's gear. A catcher's entire outfit can be pretty expensive, but we would only need one, maybe
just certain parts of it, different sizes.
And we have all the
bags,
stuff, the bases, all that stuff is already ready for it. And we've talked to Lynn Christensen with the ball backers, and she would be glad to lend it to us during the fall season.
That's with the bats and the helmets, too, if we can't get them.
If we don't have enough to supply ourselves with it, then they would be ready to... One thing we need to change with the fields, just to be with regulation, the backstop behind home plate needs to be padded, and ours is
wood or a chamber?
It's a 2 foot from the ground, two by four wood.
Yeah, it's wood, but it needed to be padded.
Otherwise, the fields are in regulation. The fences are as high as they need to be. The outfields as long as it needs to be, and the bases are all set up for the length.
Okay. And then just area teams around in this area. It's actually not as far as you might think that we would need to travel. Some of the area teams are Norfolk, Wayne, Pierce. Columbus Lakeview is a little farther away. West Point 2, Albion, Wisner-Pilger, Highway 91.
It's like a Dodge kind of consolidation.
It's the Dodge area.
GACC, O'Neill, Madison, Humphrey, Lindsay, and Loganview, Scribner-Snyder, and Columbus. So,
is Crawford in there?
I don't think Crawford's got a problem. Each player would have to have their own mitt and cleats, of course.
Well, yeah.
And we could probably have, everybody usually owns one or two pairs of sliding pants, so that could be optional.
Yeah. I guess I didn't really go into on the uniforms. We would need pants of some kind. I don't know if we would need socks, probably.
If we decide to do that, a lot would be paid for by the school. The school over.
Yeah.
If a school supports the sports, they're going to supply all the materials you need. They'll take care of the field. They'll take care of the transportation. But the problem I have is we just got done talking about co-oping for our sports because we're having trouble getting enough kids to do things. And if we would get into a co-op situation, I would be all for this because then we would have more kids to work with. Because right now, if we had a softball team, that would also compete against our cross-country team and our volleyball team, and we want to support them also, the ones that we already have. I really appreciate you girls coming up. It takes some... it's nice that you have the guts to come and do this. Because it's hard to do this in front of a bunch of people like this. So I congratulate you on that. And you had your notes there, and you were prepared, so... anyone else have any questions?
I think it is bothersome to me that we can't get a summer team to play here. And I understand the problem with the age division, but you know, there again, you're asking, once they get into high school, you're asking freshmen to play against seniors. And you can do that even during the summer leagues. I mean, there's no reason why a 14-year-old can't play on a 16 or an 18-year-old team. So that concerns me.
That problem that we have with that is we don't have enough girls for a 16 team. There might be one or two.
Right.
So we have to pull up all those 14 and unders, that some of them that may be their first year playing 14s have to play 16s. And they have no experience to go against those faster pitchers, the harder hitters,
right,
all that stuff. So that's one of the reasons why we aren't getting the teams to regulate out.
But it'll be that way if we have a high school team. Those freshmen are going to have to play against 18-year-olds, those faster pitchers.
But they could also practice with those 18-year-olds. So they would have experience to their own teammates that are older. So,
but you could do that summer league as well.
Can I say something as a parent?
Sure.
As a parent, obviously I spend a lot of time with these kids, and there's not a lot of times, one, these kids are all have to come in and do all their lifting and stuff, and a lot of kids in the summer are required to have a job. I mean, these two right here, their parents won't let it, or we have parents that won't allow them to do it. My daughter, I had to spend probably at least $1,000 this summer to go play on a traveling league. Mm-hmm. And it's bothersome that, and there's obviously coaching issues and stuff, but like she said, Carissa, I think, was just a 10-year-old coming on playing on a 14-year-old team against 16-year-olds, and it's just... It would be better if we could get them together as a team and, you know, like, some of them don't really care for volleyball, but they do it just to stay in shape, and this is where their hearts are. But as far as the summer thing, when they have to have jobs and stuff, that's why there's not a team all the time, is because they're required to go work in the summer.
But it's been a long time since Plainview. I mean, my daughter went to Pierce to play ball because we didn't have a team when she was 16. So look how many years we haven't had a team and girls have gone elsewhere to play.
And that was my point this summer. If you lose these girls that go someplace else, they're not going to come back. You know, this year there very well could be a chance to be a 14-year-old team. Well, obviously Jordan can't play in 14s no more. But once she's played down in Norfolk, she's not going to come back and play Plainview and lose all the time. You know, she's used to getting on that. You're not gonna get them back once they're gone. And I admire these three because
absolutely.
Their mother and I had nothing to do with this. They spent all this time and went and did all the work themselves. So I applaud them for
absolutely.
Taking the time to come up and do that.
There's nobody from Plainview playing on another school team. It's just
Maddie can't do it.
Maddie
Mull
went to
Norfolk
moved schools
because
we couldn't get his team started here. There has been other schools that girls are transferring to other schools because they can't get a team started.
For the whole school.
Yeah.
Just for the school.
That's one of the problems that we are looking at if we don't consolidate is that we're going to be losing schools out of this district because the opportunities are not there.
Yeah. I think it's very stark.
And I ain't going to lie. Right here's three of them that play volleyball. That, you know, and most of them on the list would go from volleyball.
That might solve one problem. You might have a softball team, but now we've got maybe two
no
or three
volleyball.
Problems with volleyball, cross country, and golf that we're fighting, you know, so.
But if you did co-op with Creighton, it's
yeah, if we co-op, it's not a big issue.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, we have
absolutely.
No problems, whatever that.
All four.
And I've talked to other girls from Creighton, and they said if we will co-op, they will play the sports, and there will be enough teams.
No,
there will
absolutely.
Be enough numbers for a softball team and a volleyball team at the same time to coexist, as long as with cross country and all the other sports.
Yeah. I agree. That's
I agree
another,
also.
Another advantage that would come from co-oping.
Exactly, yeah.
Also,
so,
I'd point out also that all those
two girls interested in still playing volleyball also,
yeah, we
that,
talked
they,
to them
that
too.
They would be interesting to co-op. I guess I want to ask if the students or the girls would be are in favor of co-oping,
yeah.
I guess is what I wanted to ask.
Most of them are.
The
girls in Creighton also want this. They've been trying to get a softball team going too. They've been trying to do the research and stuff. And they're running into the problem. They don't have enough girls, but they said if we do co-op, we'll have more than enough to have two teams.
Are they talking to their school board tonight?
I don't.
Just to point out, you know, this was the main reason why we were talking about consolidation before. This is one of the reasons, because you don't have enough kids to do things that you want to do. But co-oping or some other plan may be needed here. Any other questions anybody has?
So to answer, it will be dependent upon if we co-op with other schools. But thank you. You did an excellent job.
Thank you.
Girls.
Oh, no, you don't get to
wait
the meeting early.
Okay, next item is discuss committee options for the old building. Okay, we have three board members that are on that committee, myself, Mike, and Steve, correct?
No, me.
No, Jason and Mike and myself, right? For the old building. And we have three teachers that are on the committee, Michelle Mosel, Tammy Schindler, and Dean Boyer, all who were in that building. And we have three community members that are on it, and those are Kevin Lingenfelter, Jackie King, and Jim Kanowski. And so we're going to get together. I would like to get together Wednesday of this week, if that's at all possible. Michelle, would you be able to do it Wednesday?
What time?
You guys?
Flexible morning.
We go 7 o'clock?
Yeah, that's fine.
7 o'clock, and
church.
I think Mr. Alt's going to be gone, but Mrs. Novicki said that she would be here. I'd kind of like to just take everybody through the junior high and show the people, the board, and the community members what's going on there.
I can't be there at 7. I have a prior meeting of a council meeting.
Okay.
But Dean and Michelle will
okay,
be there. That's
yeah.
fine.
Okay.
Right here, Bob.
Yeah, it's me here.
I say you want to take the board through it?
No, just.
The committee.
The committee, the committee, all the committees. So, that's where we are on that. Any questions anybody has about that? Okay, discuss cooperative athletic programs. Okay, before the last board meeting that we had, I think maybe the day of, I called the chairman of the Creighton board and talked to him about the possibility of co-oping. And he said he really didn't have time to get it on the agenda for that meeting. He also said that he was talking to Bloomfield because Bloomfield and Creighton were the only ones left of the original five that were talking about the merger. And so they were still talking. And he said that he would bring it up. And after that meeting, he called me and he said he would want to, he was going to put it on their agenda for tonight. And so I don't know if that's an action item or a discussion item or what would happen there.
Dean Boyer is going up there, I do know that.
Okay. And part of the reason we were interested in getting this going is because, again, football has to be done before the 29th of this month so that we can get numbers in so we know we're classified and all those things. If there's some type of a situation where they want to do it, we may have a special meeting. We may have a committee meeting and decide some issues and then maybe have separate school board meetings to decide whether it's going to be done. That's a, I'm conjecturing. I don't know that that's going to happen. But it could happen. Even if that doesn't come about, we're still going to pursue. I think we want to pursue what we've been talking about for some time.
We have to do action.
We have to do action.
We can't talk anymore. But
right.
It's done.
And I think we're all agreed on that. So.
One little tidbit. We were looking up the other night at the football game. If we combine with Creighton and the numbers that we both just sent in for what we're going to have for NSAA the next, those three grades. If you added Creighton and us together, we would be right at the level where Wayne is at. That'd be the size school we'd be at. We'd be bigger than Pierce, bigger than Norfolk Catholic, and right about where Wayne is. So we would be right in that mid-states type, you know, team.
Yeah.
So.
Been there before.
Oh, yeah, we've been there before. A lot smaller than Pierce.
Yeah.
We were there by ourselves. We won a lot of times. Any other questions on that or discussion?
So, after the meeting tonight, we're going to contact Creighton again and see what they came up with.
Right.
If they say no, we don't want to do anything, should we give Osmond a call? I mean,
I think we ought to give Osmond. We'll jump on board whoever wants to come with us first.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And let's get it resolved. And then if the other school wants to come sometime,
yeah.
None of those guys are going to, they might be okay now, but their numbers are going to fall off eventually too. And then they're going to be in the same boat that we're going to be in 2 years.
Yep. And somebody said this, and I think it might have been Donna. The biggest issue we have is that our kids, we won't have the two quarters of JV basketball. I mean, this isn't just a football issue. This is, our kids aren't going to get to play. I mean, we all coached, all of us. We had how many kids out for basketball? I mean, you'd have to sit.
We had freshman teams. We had JV.
Yeah, and they got to play, and they got to work their way up. And if you go tonight, which Jason has not seen much of this because he hasn't been able to go, it's a totally different game when you watch our kids play in a JV game as opposed to out on the varsity. As my husband said, our son's arms are just too scrawny and it hurts when he gets hit. Damn it! And, you know, they just don't get that. And somebody said something, well, Creighton is so successful and Pierce is so successful because they can play full JV games. They can play a full schedule. We can't even do that.
I can remember many times when we had to
Oh, we just have five.
We had a rule that we did not want freshmen going against varsity players in practice. And that was a rule. And when the AD went by, and some kid, sometimes you get really aggressive kids and they jump in and they want to get in a drill against a senior. And we were told in no uncertain terms that that was not going to happen anymore. And now we have to put them on the field like that. Mm-hmm. You know, when we had a state championship, we had a lot of those kids that played as freshmen.
They played all three.
But that doesn't always happen, that they're tough enough to do that. Sometimes you get those kids when they're freshmen and they're going up against seniors and they get beat up so bad that it changes the way they play and then they don't want to play. And I'm blamed.
Yeah.
Because you just get beat up.
I don't care if he stands on the sidelines. I just want him to have the opportunity to.
Right.
Well, we were freshmen. We never even practiced with the varsity.
How many kids you had in basketball? Yeah. Those kids did not. Your daughter played varsity volleyball as a freshman, but I can count on one hand how many kids I actually did put out there. Because even in the game of volleyball, it's a different story. It's not. Those girls hit hard, and they better be ready
absolutely.
For it.
Absolutely.
Not a bunch of weenies, because those girls get hit hard. Tracy Berniker could hit the ball very hard.
Are we going to try to be up there tonight?
Yes, there's a dirty football.
Are we going to try and be up there?
Warriors are representing us, basically, I think.
What are down here?
Well, I just think that they need to see how serious we are.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's how
that'd
that.
Be a good idea, but that's just my opinion.
What time is our meeting?
Seven.
But I would like to see us pursue and try and get this football thing before November 1st. I know it's going to be touch and go, but.
Otherwise, it's 2 years before
yeah.
we can do anything with football.
I think
we
got
to
push it.
I would like to see that too.
I would like to hear tonight.
This is not in our hands.
Oh, I know. I know.
It's not.
Can I say something?
Yes.
I agree with what Jason said. If Creighton says no, then Osmond. And I'm going to throw another name out there, and this might be way out of the ballpark, but Neely's hurt and bad. And they are looking for a situation. They are. And I know. The distance thing, I know that. But Neely's hurting.
The thing you gotta be ready for in that is you're probably no longer gonna have junior high during school.
That's
and
true.
Practices are gonna be after school because it's gonna take two classes to bus them.
Valid point. I will also add, we only had three junior high wrestlers last year. And there is some major concern about programs here.
And on the track team, too, they
track
didn't have
team
enough
as
people
well.
To fill the spots for the different events, so they could have earned a lot more points if we had some kids that get stuck in there.
Exactly.
It's everywhere.
Well, I'm just curious yet why we chose to go with Creighton first, what the reasoning was for that.
Well, we started talking to them when we came on. We were already talking with Creighton.
Oh.
We never really started with Osmond until the five-school thing started up. And if we go with Osmond, how long is it going to be before our numbers are back kind of where they are already, because they don't bring a lot of kids. But if we go with Creighton, they'll probably bring twice as many kids as Osmond. So you've got a lot more to start with. It would be a beneficial thing.
Can I add something to that? As far as being a nice fit, I think right where they're at right now, they're strong in junior high, and we have very few in the junior high.
Who's
we've
this?
Got some elementary.
Creighton.
Yeah. We've got some elementary coming up with some stronger numbers, and they do not. Just the mesh all the
it's
way down the line is
fit.
It's kind of a nice fit. But I'm not opposed to going with Osmond or anybody.
And it may end up all three of us will,
mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. goodbye. But basically.
That's
what
I call it first. That's who we've been talking to. Originally, when we started off the merger, we were talking to Creighton, and then we decided to invite the others.
But I think it was basically because of the numbers.
Right. Yeah.
Because Osmond didn't have the numbers, and we would still be two small schools combining and still have those very low numbers.
We actually started talking with Creighton probably at least 6 years ago. We talked about co-oping golf, and we talked about co-oping cross country at that time, and both of those kind of fell through at the time. And so we've had some discussions with them, and I think that's probably as much as anything.
Okay.
You know, what kind of drifted back that way. We have contacted Osmond at, different times about doing some co-oping and that. I think this thing probably would
have to get some reception from the other side.
Yeah.
Well, and we had baseball kids coming over, at least three or four baseball kids come over from Osmond. So, you know, it seems like they're pretty willing to do that.
I hate to say this, but in a way, this is kind of the old board, us three and the other three's fault to me, because Creighton was ready to go with cross country and golf and a couple of those things, and we decided not to. If we would have done that at that time, you would have never heard the word five-school merger, because we'd have been in with Creighton, we would have just kept adding more and more sports, and we'd have been fine. Never would have talked to anybody else. But we decided no, we voted not to at that meeting. And it just, I mean, it's just a whole different world because of that one vote. What it could have been.
Can't predict the future.
No. So you kind of see on Creighton's end too, they say, well, we've, you know, we've tried to work with you guys and you don't do it, you know, so why do we want to jump in there again? So we've kind of maybe lost their faith a little bit too.
Well, I had one more thing to that though, but in your defense, we were only always talking about co-oping a few programs here and there. You know, and you have one strong program and maybe they're not willing to jump up to the next level and go class C1 or class B and push that. It's got to be kind of all or none, I think.
All or none, otherwise green comes into play.
You know,
they say, oh, we're weak here, we'd love to have you here, but we're good here, we don't want you here.
No, and you can't compete against each other. It's very hard to compete against each other in one sport and not the other. So that was the right thing at that time.
That was the right thing.
Support that.
You want a motion?
That would be good.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we are in the process of trying to co-op sports with any area schools that may be interested, and we are receptive to any communication, any and all.
Steve's going up there. Do we have to give him permission to stand up for our board in the 5-minute deal and say this? Or can he just go do it and represent us?
Well, you can talk about anything we've talked about here.
You got all that written down there.
Take minutes. You want to borrow my pants?
Obviously, none of us can make any decisions for the board.
No.
See what happens when you show up late. I just thought that it would look good.
And I agree
absolutely.
With you.
That
if the board never showed up and spoke.
I think it looked like we're serious.
Yeah.
That we,
right.
You know.
I guess I was expecting all of us, but if we don't all go, I guess that's fine too.
I don't
too.
Think we would
do
that.
No.
Three.
Oh, you can't. Okay.
Then you have a meeting.
Gotcha.
By the way,
top school that she's
on the wall, which I forgot to say earlier.
But we give you permission to speak your mind on our behalf.
Yes. Okay, Patty, you want to go next?
I do. Go
fast.
Okay, I'll go fast. Really, there isn't a whole lot in here. You guys can read all of this. Brooke gets a copy of it, so he'll publish all of it in the paper. The only one that I really want to focus on primarily, Mr. Alt will touch on it more, is that I was kind of doing the happy dance in the office trying to get him to get into the A-Quest and look up the new prototype, which if you want to see it, I have a copy of it on my desk. I meant to bring it, I forgot. But the new prototype that, remember I said all those really intelligent people got up there and decided that you would be a needs improvement, good, great, excellent school, and I wanted to be a 4, we were a 4. Yes.
Very good. Very good.
So he can explain that in more detail.
What's there to say?
And he already said, I don't have to put it on there because everybody's going to know anyway. And I was pretty excited because I was told very few schools would get a 4. And so we are no longer ranked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the state. This is how many little bit percent will be the 4s, big percent will be 3s, big percent will be 2s, and then there'll be the needs improvement that's at the bottom. And then those bottom 3 schools, which is going to be a shocker, they say, it will not be the people you think it's going to be, will be the ones that get designated for the states and the federales to come in and help you get your school together.
Is that categorized by class or is the whole state?
Whole state, all thrown
one
together.
One group.
So there's three total schools in the state that'll be at the bottom.
That'll be at the bottom. And they could be, at our last meeting, and we're divided, and even though we're not a middle school, we are middle school. We have an elementary and a middle school, which for us is our seventh and eighth grade, and high school. And it could be one school that's at the bottom and everything. That'd be bad. But we were a four, so I was very excited. Obviously, the quarter is up on Friday. We have an in-service plan on the 23rd. We'll be working on some school improvement things again. I'm all very excited about that. And April 6th, some of you will have to come on April 6th if it works into your schedule, because that's our external review, and I'll want to talk to a few board members and those kinds of things. And we went to a school improvement meeting on the 22nd and the 23rd. The afternoon of the 23rd was awful. The rest of it was all pretty good, but it was all on frameworks. So MAP scores came out. They all turned out really well. If they would take that as our state test instead of us having to do NISA, our kids would be geniuses. So. Okay.
Thank you.
Done. What about Jason?
Action items. Approval on first reading, board policy 404.11.
Okay, I think these first four policies, we talked about it not last month, but the month before, these brought up for first reading. These are policies that hurt all the last legislative sessions, things that exist yet for policy manuals. So, the 404.11 is on facilities for milk expression, is saying you have to designate a place so that you have a mother that wants to express milk and that they need to have a place where somebody's not walking in on them, that type of thing. So this is something that's happening anyhow, most schools. One of the things it did say is they don't want it to be a restroom, but Ms. Novick and I did talk about the situation. I think the best place we do have over here in the high school would be the restroom just off the nurse's office, which is not like a regular restroom where people are going to walk into all the time. We're not going to separate away from stuff. And then over in the elementary, we thought the storage room by the in the back part of the library, which we could close, cover the windows to that, and that could be locked, would be the best place to probably have. So
the restroom over here, is there room for a chair so I don't have to sit on
the
stool?
Yes, there's a wheelchair in there all the time.
A what, a wheelchair?
Yes.
So they're going to sit in a wheelchair?
No, I'm just saying there's room for that in there, so yeah, it's pretty big.
I'll make a motion to approve on first reading board policy 404.11, facilities for milk expression.
I'll second.
Mike, second then? Myself, yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, motion carries. Approve on first reading board policy 508.17, return from pediatric cancer.
And I think I mentioned when we discussed this one came about, it's a lot like the one on concussions. Return to learn protocol for that. And I think you can just imagine if you have a student that has had cancer coming back, they're going to probably have missed some school. It's going to be a pretty traumatic time. Those students need a little, I'm just going to say, extra attention, in different ways. Maybe, they may not have the capacity to be able to sit and concentrate, like all students could. So I think it's probably something that, I think it's probably a very good policy.
I'll make a motion to approve on first reading board policy 508.17.
Second. Mike, second.
Myself, yes. Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Vicki?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Motion carries. Approve on first reading board policy 902.02, construction plans and specifications. Can't even say it right.
Specifications.
What do you say?
The biggest thing in this one is the state statutes changed from having to put out a project on bids from an amount of money at $40,000, they moved that to $100,000. And I really don't know how many years at $40,000 have been on the books. But you can imagine construction costs, what they've done over a period of 10, 15, 20 years has gone up. And And I just think this is a lot more reasonable amount of money that we should have to put it out for competitive bids. And just on the things that we do, like on our roofing projects and that, you know, pretty easy to get $40,000 just on a repair bill anymore. Not a major construction, but repair bills. So. And the other thing in there, it does allow for a couple construction management risk and design build methods, which I think probably when this was written with $40,000, those weren't really accepted ways to go about a project. So those are the two main things.
Make a motion to approve on first reading board policy 902.02, construction plans and specifications.
I'll second.
Steve?
Yes.
Vic?
Yes.
Myself, yes.
Mike, yes.
Mike, yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Motion carries. Approval on first reading board policy 902.04, bids and boards and construction contracts.
Okay, again, the main part of this one is the $100,000 is mentioned in there, and then it does give some, just some general direction as far as soliciting bids and that. I actually took this policy over another suggested one. The other one was pretty specific, the timelines and things that you had to do, and I think this one's a lot more general, and I think it'll work a lot better. You know, we would follow, like when we did the roofs, you know, we advertise, and, you know, I think we run them in the local paper, we run them in, you know, like the Norfolk paper, so you're getting a little wider, you know, exposure to it, and then, you know, we set a date that the bids have to be in by, you know, and make that pretty specific. You know, we write up specifications, you know, you have to meet these certain things, and, you know, all of those types of things would be done.
I make a motion to approve on first reading board policy 902.04, bids and awards for construction contracts.
I'll second.
Moved and seconded.
Yes.
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Myself? Yes. It's approved. Next two. Ready for number 11, right?
Yeah.
Approve on second reading board policy 905.07, safety drills.
Okay, this one, the main thing was that the legislature had, we have to do tornado drills with it, so that was the part that was mainly added with it.
I'll make a motion, go ahead.
Make a motion to approve the second reading board policy 905.07, safety drills.
I'll second.
Moved and seconded. Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Myself?
Yes.
Steve? Approve on our second reading board policy 508.05, emergency plans and drills.
Okay, and this one, what we did with that policy is cut a lot of the wording out of it. It basically says that our emergency plans and drill will refer to the policy you just approved on second reading, and refers to the annual emergency safety plan, which is the plan that Corey has spent half his life developing. Which we're very appreciative.
A little slow.
I'll make a motion to approve on second reading board policy 508.05, emergency plans and drills.
Yes.
Steve?
Okay.
Yes.
Myself, yes. Mike?
Yeah.
Mike?
Yes.
Yes. Motion carries. Okay, the last one to approve on first and second reading board policy 502.015, full-time and part-time enrollment.
And after the board discussed this one, I think the discussion leaned towards changing the wording on allowing part-time enrolled students to participate in extracurricular activities, and asked that wording be changed. So that is actually the last sentence there on extracurricular activities. Now it reads that students enrolled on a part-time basis will not be allowed to participate in extracurricular activities. I don't think there's anything else changed in the entire policies.
Make a motion to approve on first and second reading board policy 502.015, full-time and part-time enrollment.
Is there a second?
Second.
Yes.
Yes.
Myself, yes. Mike?
No.
Mike, yes.
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Okay. 2014-15 audit report.
Okay, we did have our audit done for last year's financial year. You should have, inside the book, there should have been a letter from the Mike Palmer, who is our auditor. Basically, announced to everything, I believe, is okay, I hope. He said he wasn't going to recommend we get sent to jail, so that was a good thing. Mike does a really good job for us, and Imogene does a terrific job of organizing things. When he comes, she has everything laid out. He came, what, at 10:30 one day and left about 1 or 1:30 and come back the next day. He was there a couple hours, took a few things with him, and then he showed up on Friday and had done. So it didn't take him very long. And I compliment Imogene because she has everything right there for him. I don't even know if he didn't even look very much stuff up this year. Sometimes he digs through files and looks stuff up.
So give us a reduced rate then.
Yeah.
But I will say this, it is, from my perspective, I think Imogene would agree on this. Having a person like Mike to work with is worth a lot of money because he's familiar with the school and he is very, very easy to work with. And I think it was this morning we were talking about that we, you know, we don't, he doesn't suggest many changes, but what we do is during the year, if we have a question, we either call him or email him, and he tells us, well, this, you know, you should probably code this way. And then we don't have to worry about it at the end of the year when we're audited, so he doesn't have to go back in and change it on the AFR or anything. So it's pretty much taken. So
he's a resource.
Yeah. You know, he does a good job with it. So.
Thank you, Irene.
You're welcome.
I make a motion to approve the 2014-2015 audit report as presented.
I'll second.
Moved and seconded. Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
So, yes?
Yes.
Dave? Motion carried. Discuss act on replacing air conditioning unit. Put this item on.
Yeah. Okay, last month, if you remember, we had this on as an action item, and then the discussion led around that we should, maybe while we were doing that, we should take a look at tying that into an air conditioning unit, maybe on the pirate gym. So we contacted Rasmussen Mechanical, which does our air conditioners and that, and they suggested that if we do anything with the pirate gym, it be left as a separate unit, because if we don't, it's going to be hard to regulate that temperature. You know, to have something up here and you know, run that thing all the time to, you know, cool the gym during the summer and that type of thing. So so that is their recommendation, and that's why I put that back on here. I think we do need, my recommendation is that we replace the unit, because it has been pretty much nickel and dime us, I should say, $500 to $1,000 us, you know, for several years now. So I think we need to replace it and get it fixed. Now, when I sent out the letter, the board letter, I didn't have any idea what the pirate gym would cost, but a couple gentlemen from Rasmussen showed up on Friday morning and with an estimate for that one, and they're estimating for the pirate gym that's going to be around $85,000 for the air conditioning. So, just to give you an idea. Also, we had asked, you know, at one time we asked them about the band room and the classroom in the shop, you know, talking about that, and then, you know, I think when we started talking about maybe, you know, redoing that, we kind of put that on, thinking about putting that on hold, and that's what I told them. I said, I don't foresee maybe that is happening right away, but they did also, had been working on and gave me estimates on that, and I'm not sure I got the right one here. The shop, and this is just for the classroom, would be a little over $28,000, and the band room would be almost $39,000 is what they're asking. But they also said that if we would, you know, if we do something with that, you know, the old building and build classrooms, they said you'd be able to put something in there that's a lot more efficient and it's not going to cost you probably as much money to do it because of that. So
you probably could put something in that would cover those if we build on the new classrooms and
put that
and all that stuff would all be one.
Yes. Yes.
Except for the pirate gym.
Yeah, the pirate gym, I think, would still be a separate unit.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because you only need one.
Well, the thing is, if that unit's going to cost that amount of money, what's it going to cost to cool it, just in electricity? You know, this must be an awful big unit.
Most of those things, cool, it's not so tough to
no.
keep them cool. It's when you,
but do you need them cool all summer?
Yeah, you probably have to, because you got stuff going on in there all summer, too. So.
My big question on the pyro gym was condensation. What are you going to do about that? Because if you start running cool air through those vents, at first they said, well, you probably have to insulate those. I talked to them, they said, you shouldn't have to. And I didn't get like a 15-degree difference in temperatures or something before it's going to be a condensation problem. And I said, we're redoing that floor there. I don't want to have water dropping on it.
There's no insulation probably anywhere in that gym, ceiling, walls, or anything.
I mean, he was talking about actually the vents, because those vents that go across for the heating, using those vents to, you know, bring air conditioning down and drop down to those vents. But then you got cool air running through those vents with that hot, humid air up there next to them. And he says it shouldn't be a problem. But anyhow, that was kind of a side thing. I also have that in my superintendent's report. I thought I'd bring it up. I would suggest
is he going to give us any, if we decided to do the gym, would he cut any money off because he's already here doing this one?
I don't know. I didn't ask him that. If he did them at the same time, but
they
have all the stuff.
Crane here to set it up there.
Right.
Like that. Probably wouldn't be. I mean, if it was $5,000, he still wouldn't spend $8,000.
$5,000 we would have to spend later on.
Well, we might want to wait and find out what, if we do co-op, what sports we're actually going to have here.
This we're going to need no matter what.
This one? Yeah, here.
I'll make a motion to replace the air conditioning unit as presented from Rasmus Mechanical for $22,843.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Moved and seconded. Steve?
Yes.
Vicki?
Yes.
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 Mike? Yes.
Yes.
Jason? Yes. Okay.
When will they get on that? Right away? Will it be next summer?
I'm guessing.
Over the holidays?
They might try and get to it. I don't know.
We're about done with it.
Yeah, I'm about done with it now, but we definitely want it done before the spring warms up.
That's a good time.
We're not going
to
want to do
good
it
time
in
to
cold.
Mess with it now. We don't need to wait till. Activity director's report.
Girls golf is finished for us. We didn't have anybody qualify. One axe has started. They got 30 kids out with cast and crew. They started practicing and going on all that. District cross country is this week. Football, we have a couple weeks left. We don't qualify for the playoffs, so that'll be done in the Bloomfield game. In volleyball, we still got some more games to go. So, but other than that, I really don't have.
They still able to play an A, B, and C game in volleyball, or they had cut that back to like an A and B?
No, we've been able to do A, B, and C, C, JV, and varsity. I've been corrected several times on that.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Already had the principal report. President's report, I don't have anything this week.
So I'm up.
You're up.
I have the official enrollment numbers as of the last Friday in September. Our pre-K 12 enrollment was 326. I think that, if I remember correctly, down 6 maybe from last year. Since we sent that in, we lost 4 elementary students. And I think we have another 3 that are possibly leaving soon. So these are the official numbers we use to compare kind of where we're at.
So are these 9th, 10th, 11th grade, those are the numbers you send in the NSAA?
Yes. Okay, Patty mentioned the AQUEST rating on that. Actually, I don't have a whole lot more to add to it on that rating scale. We did be a 4 on the, and that's on the 2013-2014 school year. And I think that's what they call it, the prototype. every student at school is not performing above the cutoff point, they say. But yes, in the state, you know, we're one of the top schools. It just, it doesn't make any sense. But we have, I think we do have a right to be very, very proud of this. And it's something that our staff and has worked very hard at, and our students too, so. Negotiations, I did talk to Mr. Gorier the other day, reminding him we need to start negotiations by November 1. And that's just an introductory meeting, so if you got some dates you want to, times, you know, that we need to get that in the next couple of weeks, so.
Okay.
And hopefully they will get something maybe put together by tonight. And I think it was Bob, Vicky, or you on there?
I think I am. Are you on
there? I think it's Jason. One of the things that I'm looking at, hopefully, that maybe we can get done by next year is because we're already have made arrangements to redo the gym floor. We have that on a calendar already. We're looking at doing the gym lighting. I had a gentleman from, I guess, Boss Lighting has come and kind of give us an estimate on it. And then I've contacted another company. They're kind of an energy efficiency. And they do a lot with heating, air conditioning, whatever that, I mean, they'll come in and do your own system if you want them to. And I told them we're not looking at that, but as far as lighting, I'm going to try and get an estimate from them. And then possibly, I talked to Mr. Clues, they redid their lights. I think they had somebody local there, and then I talked to Mr. Ham, asked him about theirs. I mean, he was at Randolph when they did theirs, so he gave me a name of a person around there that we could maybe look at. So I'm going to try and get some things put together. The gentleman that gave the estimate on this, I actually got an estimate on the Pirate Gym, on the Target Gym, and then on the Weight Room. And we're looking at LED lights. They'd be fairly expensive to put in compared to the fluorescent ones, but they have new fluorescent ones that are a lot more efficient than, say, these that we have in here. But from what he is saying, if we would install these, we would they would pay for themselves between 2 to 3 years in what we would save in electricity. So
LEDs.
LEDs.
The new fluorescents are super efficient.
They're not as efficient as these.
Yeah, they're better than these,
but I don't think they're as efficient as these. When I was talking to Mr. Hamm, and I asked him about his, and I kind of gave an idea what they were talking about the cost here. And he says, well, he thought they got, and this was just for the materials, that like Pirate Gyms would be around $12,000 to $13,000. He said, well, he thought they did materials and labor and everything and put theirs in. But when I started talking to him, his were the, I don't remember which one, the T5 or T8. I think it's T5s, I think, what they put in the fluorescent bulbs.
Yeah.
So they're not as, like I said, not as efficient as the LEDs and that. So, but anyhow, I will try to keep getting more information on that so that we can, you know, make a decision. I hope to make it by maybe mid semester so that we get it on the calendar for next year. And I'd like to, if we're going to do it, I'd like to do that before we do the floor, so we don't have to worry about rolling up scaffolding and that over. So,
do you think we need to do both gyms and what else?
Well, we were looking at the Pirate Gym, the Target Gym, and then the Weight Room.
But the $12,000 was just...
That was just the Pirate Gym. That one's for 12 and 13. The Target Gym is right at 4,000, and the Weight Room would be about 600. But again, that's just for equipment. That's no labor.
No wiring, because you're going to probably have a lot more lights than what we have now.
It does. I don't think it includes wiring. We would have to. What I did is I asked if they would be able to install it, or if we could get somebody local to install it. It would include the cables to hang it on, but not the actual electrical wire, but most of them hang basically in the same places. So I don't think there'd be a lot of expense for the actual physical wires, but the labor to do it.
So they're as bright as the bulbs that are in there now?
They would be brighter.
LEDs are bright. Yeah. Do they make them that big? I don't know. You can get like a 4 foot, set of a 4 foot fluorescent light, they'll make a replacement LED bulb to go in there. They'll pay three times the amount, probably maybe more than that even. But they're bright. Kyle Lincolnfeld, that new shop that he put behind his house, he's allergic to fluorescent. They put all LEDs in that, and that thing's bright.
And they last a lot longer than fluorescents.
You won't have any
space them so you don't get, you know, you could get shadows across. See, he mentioned we would have to be careful because we've got that, you know, we got that net across there. We'd have to be careful, we'd have to move, like where the present light's out, we'd have to move it back so we don't get a cross shadow catching the bottom of that, so.
Do we lose any warranty or anything if we have somebody else install it?
I don't think, not, I don't think on the equipment we would, no. And whoever's installed, they would have to back up.
Just to know if that'd be a package deal.
No, it's like a tax, but like a charity or something. They're selling it now. Well, we had either him or. Jake Peterson, maybe, or, you know, I saw it from Yale, but maybe even they work together on it, I don't know.
Sure.
You know, we may be looking at a short time because the high school's out, and I think we're scheduled for, what is it, Corey, the third week in June for the floor, do you remember?
At latter part of June.
Right around there, so we're gonna have about a month window in there, so we can have them ordered and have them ready to go.
Yeah.
And it'll just matter, you know, getting them installed. NESB convention will be in November. I think we had, let's see, Vicki, I think Steve, Mike, and Mike, right? Said you were gonna go, Jason, hold on.
That was on a question mark, remember?
And I, if you wanna go, we'll still, we'll get you in somehow. If you wanna just look at, I have the names highlighted, I'll pass these around. This is the registration. And has a room thing in it. So you are registered, we have rooms. The kicker on the rooms, I was not very happy. They have such a, I think it was September 28th. You had to register first, and then you get a code, which I think is on there. And then on September 28th at 10 o'clock, you could submit your room requests. I sent my, that's at 10 o'clock. I emailed mine at 10:05. We got our fourth motel, and we are not at the site. So I apologize for that. But we got rooms at the, I think it's a Fairfield, which is on 370. It's about a 5-minute drive.
Oh yeah, that place is a real dump.
We checked
out. No, because it's new. But it isn't right there, either, and I understand that. I couldn't believe
a question mark.
10:05 and our fourth choice.
Okay, when you're there, you guys are not going to spend any time together. How many people?
No.
You guys will be in separate meetings all the time.
Well, most of the time, yeah.
Most of the time.
Sometimes you can go to meetings like that. I mean, you can
just
ride together.
I got a problem with open meetings.
No, it won't be.
No.
Okay.
There's a lot of boards out with their entire boards there. I mean, you don't have board meetings
or
anything like that, but I mean, you may have a couple people that sit in the same session. And you may sit together as a board at lunchtime or sit together during the, you know, the speakers, but you're not discussing board items either. The last thing I have is just a reminder, I will be leaving Wednesday to go to St. Louis to that NREA National Convention, and Patty went down, isn't going to go, so I'll be going down, and we'll be presenting on the topic that we put on the webinar now. Closing the achievement gap, so it's gonna be kind of exciting. I was looking at the sessions that it's a lot of research stuff, so I don't know, it may be awfully dry and boring, or it may be fairly interesting. So. Now our session will be pretty exciting.
You just gotta get there before everybody's asleep.
So that's the last thing.
Okay. Anybody else have anything?
I have a question real quick. Just for clarification, the agenda says co-oping athletic activities, the motion with athletic activities. There was some discussion about speech stuff here, and then the discussion over here about other activities. Is it all activities or just
extracurricular activities?
All extracurricular
activities. Motion only said athletic activities, so I just want to be clear that it is all.
That's what we said.
Activities. Right?
Yep.
I think you can't call it.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to be clear, so I'm saying the wrong way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe we're good.
Go, Steve, go. Go, Steve, go.
It's pretty good, Bob.
I'd go with you, but I gotta go home and fix my wife's refrigerator.
They sell those, you know.
Well, it's only a year and a half old.
Warranty.
Got it. They don't even, it's a recall.
Hey, thanks, everybody.
Yeah. They were getting tired of having a gallon of water on the floor.
That was one day last week.
Let's go with one.
Yeah, that works.